you can get a laugh with a pause. You just, by doing next to nothing, you can get the biggest reaction.
Oh, well, that.
I'm just a guy trying to do his job.
Oh, wait, what is this?
Be careful with that.
George Robert Newhart, born September 5th, 1929, and passed away on July 18th, 2024, was an American comedian and actor. He was known for his deadpan and stammering delivery style. Newhart was born in Oak Park, Illinois. His parents were Julia Pauline, a housewife, and George David Newhart, a part owner of a plumbing supply business. His mother was of Irish descent, while his father was of German and Irish descent. He went by his middle name, Bob, to avoid confusion with his father, George. The family name Newhart is of German origin. One of his grandmothers was from St. Catharines, Ontario, Canada. He had three sisters. Newhart was educated at Roman Catholic schools in the Chicago area, including St. Catherine of Siena Grammar School in Oak Park, and attended St. Ignatius College Prep High School, graduating in 1947. He then enrolled at Loyola University Chicago, graduating in 1952 with a bachelor's degree in business management. Newhart was drafted into the U.S. Army and served in the United States during the Korean War as a clerk until discharged in 1954. He briefly attended Loyola University Chicago School of Law but did not complete a degree, partly because he was asked to act unethically during an internship. Dan Sorkin, a radio station disc jockey who would become the announcer on Newhart's NBC series, introduced Newhart to the head of talent at Warner Brothers Records. He signed onto the label in 1959, only a year after its creation. Newhart's 1960 album The Button-Down Mind of Bob Newhart was the first to make number one on the Billboard charts and peaked at number two on the UK Albums Chart. Newhart would release several highly successful albums in the years that followed. Newhart's success in stand-up led to his own short-lived NBC variety show, The Bob Newhart Show, in 1961. The show lasted only a single season but earned Newhart a Primetime Emmy Award nomination and a Peabody Award. Newhart was one of the initial three co-hosts of the variety show The Entertainers. Newhart would guest star on many shows in the following years, including shows as diverse as The Alfred Hitchcock Hour and Captain Nice. Producer Grant Tinker and actress Mary Tyler Moore would work on a series called The Bob Newhart Show, written by David Davis and Lorenzo Music.
Why don't we send out for some Chinese food, guys?
Oh, I got the number of a great little Chinese place.
Well, let's call them.
It's a laundry.
I took your slacks to the cleaners. They can get the turkey gravy out in the cranberry sauce, but not the wine. So I told them to dye your slacks sparkling burgundy.
He was very interested in the starring role of psychologist Bob Hartley, with Suzanne Pleshette playing his wry, loving wife, Emily, and Bill Daly as neighbor and friend Howard Borden. By 1977, the show's ratings were declining, and Newhart wanted to end it, but was under contract to do one more season. The show's writers tried to rework the sitcom by adding a pregnancy. Still, Newhart objected. "I told the creators I didn't want any children because I didn't want it to be a show about how stupid Daddy is. But we love him so much. Let's get him out of the trouble he's gotten himself into." The staff wrote an episode that they hoped would change Newhart's mind. Newhart read the script, and he agreed it was hilarious. He then asked, "Who'll you get to play Bob?"
"Hi, I'm Larry, this is my brother Daryl, that's my other brother Daryl."
"So, how you doing?"
"Okay, except I throwed my back out last week crawling under a house."
"Sounds like a tough job."
"Wasn't a job, I just like crawling under houses."
"This is the world's smallest horse."
"And what's his name?"
"Tiny."
How do you know he's the world's smallest horse?"
"Look at him."
By 1982, Newhart wanted a new sitcom. After he talked with Barry Kemp and CBS, Newhart was created. In it, Newhart played a Vermont innkeeper. Mary Fran was cast as his wife, Joanna. In 1987, ratings began to drop. Newhart ended in 1990 after 8 seasons and 182 episodes. The last episode ended with a scene in which Newhart wakes up in bed with Suzanne Pleshette, who played Emily, his wife from the Bob Newhart Show.
You ought to make it a dream sequence because that the whole year of Dallas was a dream sequence, and St. Elsewhere ended in the dream sequence.
Honey, wake up. You won't believe the dream I just had. But don't you want to hear about it?
I knew it was a piece of television history. He knew it. We knew it. We were nervous, but I mean, we knew. And I was at the rap party afterwards.
What is it?
Well, I was an innkeeper in this crazy little town in Vermont.
You're not.
Nothing made sense in this place. I mean, the maid was an heiress. The handyman kept missing the point of things. And then there were these three woodsmen. But
that settles it. No more Japanese food before you go to bed.
And I was married to this beautiful blonde.
Go back to sleep.
Good night, Ellen.
What do you mean, beautiful blonde?
TV Guide later chose the twist ending as the best finale in television history. In 1992, Newhart returned to television with a series about a cartoonist named Bob. The ensemble cast included Lisa Kudrow, but the show did not develop a strong audience and was canceled shortly after the start of its second season despite good critical reviews. On The Tonight Show following the cancellation, Newhart joked that he had now done shows called The Bob Newhart Show and Newhart and Bob, so his next show was going to be called The. In 1997, Newhart returned with George and Leo on CBS with Judd Hirsch and Jason Bateman. Newhart would appear as a guest in several shows. In 2013, he appeared in an episode of the 6th season of The Big Bang Theory, playing the aged Professor Proton, Arthur Jeffries, a former science TV show host turned children's party entertainer, for which he was awarded a Primetime Emmy Award.
Grab your goggles, put your lab coat on. Here he comes, Professor Proton.
I can get as close to you as I want without my mom saying it's going to ruin my eyes.
Is he dangerous?
His first major motion picture, Hell Is for Heroes, was released in 1962. In it, he played a private.
Asking me if there's anything you can do for me, is that clear?
Yes, sir. When should I come in your office and ask you if there's anything I can do for you?
When I'm not there.
What do I do then?
Whatever has to be done.
Yes, sir.
Other major film roles include Catch 22, Legally Blonde 2, and Elf.
There are only three jobs available. The first is making shoes at night while the old cobbler sleeps.
Lazy bum. Couldn't even make a clog.
As you can imagine, it's dangerous having an oven in an oak tree during the dry season.
I want to make shoes!
But the third job, it's the profession that every elf aspires to, and that is to build toys.
Well, why don't you take the shortcut through the zoo?
Miss Bianca, I don't know. I mean, it's, it could be risky.
We were just cold and hungry with nowhere to go.
Oh, well, why didn't you say so in the first place?
He loaned his voice to the Rescuers 1 and 2 animated features and the 1998 Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, his last film role as a cameo in 2011's Horrible Bosses. His last television role was as Professor Proton on 3 episodes of Young Sheldon between 2017 and 2020. Newhart met his future wife, Virginia Lillian Ginny Quinn, daughter of character actor Bill Quinn, through an introduction by Buddy Hackett. Bob and Ginny were married on January 12, 1963. The couple had 4 children, Robert, Timothy, Jennifer, and Courtney, and 10 grandchildren. Both Roman Catholics, the couple raised their children in that faith. Bob was a member of the Church of the Good Shepherd and the related Catholic Motion Picture Guild in Beverly Hills, California. Ginny died at age 82 on April 23, 2023. The Newhart and Rickles families were close, often vacationing together. Don Rickles and Newhart appeared together on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno on January 24, 2005, the Monday following Johnny Carson's death, reminiscing about their many appearances on Carson's show. The two also appeared together on Newhart's television sitcom and for previous episodes of The Tonight Show, where Newhart or Rickles were guest hosts. The friendship was memorialized in Bob and Don, A Love Story, a 2023 short documentary film by Judd Apatow, released by The New Yorker, featuring interviews, as well as home videos, with both families. In 1985, Newhart was hospitalized for secondary polycythemia, a condition attributed to his years of heavy smoking. He recovered after several weeks and eventually quit smoking. Newhart died from complications of several short illnesses at his home in Los Angeles on July 18, 2024, at the age of 94. Upon his death, President Joe Biden released a statement that read, "Today, we mourn the loss of Bob Newhart, a comedy legend and beloved performer who kept Americans laughing for decades. That was our show for today. What did you think? What was your favorite Bob Newhart role? Did you know about his vast career? Let me know your thoughts in the comments section below. While you're at it, I'd be honored if you subscribe to my channel, click the little bell to stay informed, share this video, and check out my Carl Vincent Vampire Hunter franchise, also in the comments section. And, until next time, this is Axel and for Kevin Givens saying live long and prosper, may the force be with you and keep reaching for the stars."